6 years ago, I was in a medically induced coma. My organs were shutting down. When I woke up, I couldn't walk.
I grew up on a street called Rosewood. And believe it or not, Rosewood was considered the worst street in the state of Illinois. Everything you can think of happened on that street. Kids that we grew up with on our block, there were many who either passed or did end up in prison.
I was diagnosed with a brain tumor when I was 18. It caused me not to be able to have children. That was really all I ever wanted to be, was a mom.
I closed the business that I had had for three-ish years. My boyfriend and I broke up, so I had to move out of my apartment. I didn't have the future that I thought that I was gonna have, you know, marrying this guy and having this successful business. Now I'm living in someone's basement.
I'd been out for several weeks. Then when I woke the first day out, my husband at the time came in and said he was leaving, that he wanted a divorce.
My main concern was raising my kids and make sure, you know, that they were safe and their life was in order.
My name is Katie Griffith. I am on a path to become the first female to get a contract with an affiliate baseball team.
I really had to give up the thought of having kids because it really didn't look like that was going to happen before I actually found out that I was pregnant, which was amazing. My name is Shannon Meddy.
My name is Latasha Johnson. I am in the real estate business.
My name's Kelly Hager. I'm the CEO of the Kelly Hager Group, which is a real estate team out of St. Louis, Missouri. The great thing about when you surround yourself with the right people is you really become a team. Right now we are in a pretty tough climate in America. People are feeling lonely and not connected.
Sometimes, you know, you have to face the scariest to get over the hump.
For women, we shouldn't compete with each other, we should complement each other.
The world is filled with people who want to do, and if we can reach them and just move that meter a little bit, I think it could be a seismic shift for all of us.
People look out for each other, you know?
There's a great sense of pride here.
Adversity does not discriminate. Hope at the Crossroads is a mesh of many stories that we can all learn from.
And that's what our work is all about. We want these women to understand that where they are does not define who they are.
I got stronger and stronger. And yeah, I was 24, 25 with a cane. And every time they say you can't, I say I can.
We will be able to show a path or a roadmap or a playbook of success.